Welcome to our next session. In this session, we'll be studying about bar charts. In our previous session, we have seen pie charts, right? So we are going to see how bar charts can be drawn using this R language, right? So bar chart is nothing but a pictorial representation in which different numerical values of variables are represented by their length or the height, right? So bar chart can be represented either in terms of vertical or in horizontal way, right? Of equal width, the bins or the bars which you see will be of equal length. Basically, bar chart is used for summarizing a set of categorical data, right? It is shown through rectangle bars which are proportional to the value of the variables, right? We use simple as bar plot function. Right, in there are different parameters which we'll be seeing. As I'll write it down here, we have h, x and y values, then for title we have main, we have names.arg and color. Right, so these are different parameters which we'll be seeing in bar plot. So we need these values first and then pass on as an argument for this function bar plot. So h represents a vector or a matrix, right? So you can take a matrix as well as a vector. In our previous session for pie chart, we have used vector, right? So here we'll be using matrix, which will be having numerical values to display that bar plot. X represents as label for x-axis, wherein y will be as a label for y-axis. We can write it as x lab, y lab also. Main will represent the title of your entire bar chart. Names.arg is the vector of names that will be appearing under each bar. Right, so we'll be having horizontal or vertical bar chart. So for particular bar chart, for a single bar you need to give a name. So for that you can use names.arg, and then we have col, the colors to represent your bar chart, right? So initially we'll take some vector values and then go for different combinations. So we'll be using some matrix or some values of vector, and then we'll see how you can have a visualization of bar chart. So we'll take first h and some values. I'll load this. Okay, now simply use the function bar plot, and what is the your vector name is h. Click on it and I'll zoom this. See here, I'm having those values, and these each bar represents a bin, right? It is called as bin. So it will be of equal width, right? Height will be differing according what values you are having. Now what we'll do is we'll try to label title and see how different colors can be used in this bar plot. We'll take one more. I'll take some string now. March, April, May and June. Okay, so we have taken two vectors now. Now what we are going to do is we'll be assigning these into, I'll edit here only, h we have already, names.arg equal to the second variable as m, xlab, we'll give month, name as month, then we have ylab as revenue generated, right, as per the months, then we'll set the color to green. Okay, we'll give a title also. Revenue bar chart, and we set the border color as red. Right. Now you can see this chart is little bit fancy. You have changed the color. You filled the color, given a title to this chart, and you can see here the border color is set to red. Right. So you can make some changes in this way. If you want this file to save, anytime you go to this export option over here on the right side, click on it. There are options to save as image or in a PDF, right? Or you can copy to clipboard and paste into another applications also, right? Now this chart can be grouped or stacked into different data. So this one entire bar can represent multiple information, right? So we can create bar charts with a group of bars and stacks using matrices, because matrices will hold rows and columns and will have many number of input values, right, for each single bar. So that can be represented in terms of stack, right? So we need a library for that. I'll show you here. Library name is R Color Briefer. See, now it is previously installed on my machine. If you are using for the first time, use this command install.packages and the package name, right? Install this, again load your library and then go for this codes, right? So what we'll do is we'll use this month from a 5 month data. It is up to month and I'll change here to January. So we're having Jan, Feb, March, April and May. Okay, so let's load this. Then we'll have some different regions as West, North and South. I'll load this also. Now what we need to do, we need to take some matrix values, right? Same as we implemented matrix, take some integer values into it. We'll define rows and columns. N row will be 3 by 5. By row equal to true. Okay, I'll load this now. Load into memory. Now the last part to represent your bar. Now we are having a lot of information, so let's go for plotting. First we have as values, then we'll give a title, total revenue generated, then another function as name arguments as months, x represents month, wherein y represents revenue. And we'll give some color. You can pick up these colors from color library. In the first session of pie chart, we have seen there are 657 different colors. So you can check out those library and use over here. These are the color names, right? You can see here a chart which defines you different information by this using this color combination of blue, pink and a little bit slightly golden type orange, right? So in this way you can define the information from single bar with having three different kinds of information, right? As in pie chart we have saw legends, same here in bar plot we can also have legends. I'll show you. I will create a legend in the top left corner. Left, then we'll have some regions. We'll use the same colors which we have used here so that it will be matching up with the actual visualization. Fill these color here and I'll execute. So see here, right? So we can switch this in top right. Bottom will not be visible because this will be embedded onto your bar chart, right? So this will be displaying in this way, that blue represents west, pink as north, and this yellow orange type as south, right? So this is how you can represent stacked bar charts by using these number of colors. Okay, so this was all about a basic introduction on how you can visualize bar charts. In next session we will see what are box plots.